Geordie was a fisherman, and he worked down the mine. There was a coal mine in Killeen. He worked there as well. But singing was his big love. Geordie would sing a song even if he'd just come here to visit when he was alive, when he'd come here to visit with me. Maybe him and me would sing half a dozen of songs, just the two of us here.
But it was off to India I had to go, for to fight and face the foe, not knowing when a ball it would cut me down and leave my love in Lisburn town. So it's farewell, father and mother too, likewise my true love I bid adieu. These cruel foes have cut me down, so goodbye, love and Lisburn town.
I remember one night being in bed here, and it was a time before there was any troubles, and I left the back door open for the family coming in from a dance, and I was in bed, and this fella just arrived into the bedroom to me, just to the side of the bed, and he says, "Get up." It was about 12:30 or 1:00, and I said, "What's wrong?" He says, "We're coming from cockfights, so we want a bit of a sing song." So I get up, and there's about 10 men here in the kitchen, in this house here, all just wanting a sing-song after the day at the cockfights. That was all they wanted, a bit of a song and a cup of tea and a bit of a party.
I think a lot of instrumentalists even inherited an old style without knowing it from traditional singing. For a basic understanding of the Irish tradition, one would have to have some kind of ear for the old style traditional singing in Irish.
Music and the Irish language to me was very close. Because if you hadn't it from the cradle, you would never really learn it. The first time I ever discovered the fiddle, and this is no lie, it's a terrible instrument. I used to be watching my father, I still remember it, out of the cot, and me walking the cot, and this is true. A lot of people would think I was telling lies, but I'm not. And when I would be finished playing, the only thing, I was watching him up all the time. And I could see, I thought the web of the bow was going under the string. And I'd be watching night after night, how did he get the bow out of the fiddle?